motherfucker.
What's going on, moviegoers? If you're new to the channel, my name's Christian. Welcome to SeaWorld Productions. You guys, this is some interesting news that I had no idea that was actually going to happen. Because after the last movie, after the last Predator bombed critically and at the box office, I didn't expect to see any kind of Predator movie for a long time. I love Predator. I love the first film. I love the second film. I love the first Alien vs. Predator. I love Predators, but Alien vs. Predator Requiem was straight up garbage. And you have the Predators that came out, was it last year or the year before, directed by Shane Black. Terrible. Garbage. Unbelievable. That movie was bad. I'm sorry. Nothing about that movie I liked. They legit, Shane Black starred in the first Predator. And he tried to make that film feel like the essence of what the first one had. And it failed drastically. Even had some of the same music. I was just like, bro, the dialogue in this movie was straight up ass cheeks. It was so bad, like ass cheeks. Some of the worst dialogue I've ever heard in any kind of movie. The ultimate Predator who was completely CGI. Unbelievable. I can go on a whole rant about how that movie was straight up booty cheeks, but I won't. But apparently Disney and 20th Century Studios are now going to be rebooting the Predator franchise. And this has already been in the works for the last 3 to 4 years, confirmed by the director, Dan Trachtenberg. I think that's how you say his name. He directed Cloverfield 10 Lane, which I really, really love. He's writing and directing the new Predator movie. Now, this is going to be a reboot. This isn't Predator 5. It's not a continuation of Shane Black, the Predator. It's not. And I'm so happy about that. But where can you take the story? Where can we take this franchise and turn it around to what the first two films had? Even the Predators, like I said, or Alien versus Predator, you know, the first film. And if you don't count the whole AVP, you know, franchise to be along with, you know, Predator's solo films, okay, then I understand that. But this film needs this franchise, it legit needs a lightning bolt of energy, of life, of passion. Because I feel like we've completely just fell away from that. And it's so unfortunate because you can capitalize off this character. I mean, Predator is, how could you not love Predator? It's just dope. Along with Alien, you know what I mean? But the whole, you know, the recent Alien movies, you know, Prometheus was okay. The Alien Covenant I thought was not good to me. But I'm curious to see where they're going to take this. You know, it's funny because the director confirmed, like I said, that this has been an ongoing thing for the last couple of years. Shane Black has been working on his movie for the last couple of years. And when it came out, it was a booty. So they already knew that they were going to reboot it, like from the jump. And I'm happy that now that Disney owns, obviously, with 20th Century Fox. Or 20th Century Fox. What is it called? 20th Century Studios? Yeah, it's just called 20th Century Studios, not 20th Century Fox anymore. But I'm happy that Disney's kind of like, okay, well, we're still going to capitalize and use this franchise. Just because we're a kid-friendly company doesn't mean we're not going to continue on these great characters. And I love that. I really do like that. Like, thank you, Disney. And apparently, this is a huge rumor that, you know, Disney is, for the Disney Plus app, are creating an adult section on the app that will feature 20th Century Studios movies. I'm like, oh, that's what I'm talking about. Expand, create. Instead of throwing it on Hulu, just create a separate division within the app. Obviously, kids won't be able to access it unless they have some kind of passcode or password from the parents, which majority of kids do nowadays, because let's just keep it real. Kids aren't the same anymore. But I'm really curious to see how far they go with that. You get what I'm saying? And you know, with the announcement of Deadpool 3 officially coming out and Ryan Reynolds coming back, and that's going to be R-rated, there's still a glimmer of hope that, you know what I mean, all the acquisitions that Disney bought, you know, they still plan to keep things alive and continue on. And that's a huge, huge, huge win for fans. It really is. But I'm hyped about this Predator movie. But I'm very skeptical. I'm very skeptical. Because after the last one, I was just like, why? 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 Like, just why? Let's go back to what the original one had. Like, even like the second one with my boy Danny Glover, you know what I mean? The streets of LA. I really dug that whole feel of it. You know what I mean? I think the first one took place in the jungle, and, you know, second one took place in the streets of LA. Dope. You know what I mean? Creative idea, loved it. But let's really go back to what the first one had. The first one was so perfect. It was perfect from start to finish. And you have Arnold Schwarzenegger. Come on, man. Like, it was so good. He was so good. The whole beginning scene with him and Carl Weathers. Dylan, you know, they shake hands and you see the massive biceps of these two. Just the casting, too. The casting for that first film was so good. So good. Like I said, I'm excited about this. I am. I like the director. If he's very passionate about it and he wants to continue on to what the originals had, then by all means, let's do that. Or even if he's like, okay, well, this is going to be a third installment. You know, it's going to take place after Predator 2. Then I'm with that, you know, disregarding everything else. Even though, like I said before, I did like the Predators. I thought that was a cool concept, how they're all crash landed on that planet and the parachutes and all, you know, that was dope. I thought that was cool. But even if, like I said, they decide to do the whole, you know, Halloween thing where they're disregarding the franchise and, you know, doing a continuation after the first film or the second film, then it could work. It really could work. But, like, I want to know where they're going to take the story. Where they're going to take the story, who's going to be the lead, things like that. I mean, don't be afraid to cast a manly lead again, you know what I'm saying? Because Arnold fucking killed that shit. He was really good in that first movie. Like I said, the whole cast was. But it's going to be interesting to see what really happens with this film, you guys. But this is going to be good. But post your comments down below. Let me know what you guys think about Predator Reboot officially in the works. What are your thoughts? What are your opinions? Where would you like to see the franchise go? And let's keep it to practical effects. Put somebody in a suit. Don't CGI, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you know, the last one had somebody in a suit. Okay, that was cool. But you CGI the whole big Predator at the end, which was terrible. He was terrible looking. Just terrible. Unbelievable. Didn't wear no armor. Didn't wear no mask. Ugh, just, I can go about this all day. But please, post your comments down below, you guys. Let me know what you guys think about this officially being in the works. Peace. We out.